So good day to all. Now my today's topic is new concept in wildlife tourism as related to human psychology. Now why I have chosen this subject? That's what I want to tell you. Wildlife tourism is a niche business and it is affordable by those who has got money, especially in India. So when I was looking for increasing the business, I came to know that middle class people also interested to go in a forest and see the wildlife, but they cannot afford money to stay in a good national parks and wildlife resorts. So I was thinking what to do. Then I could able to locate sites in remote villages and near national parks where people are having their own farm and everything, and where some wildlife used to come. So I thought, why not to take people to such places? And that's why it kept in mind to start such type of business, so that even a middle class people can go and see wildlife and enjoy it, because they are the lovers of nature. This is one fact. Another fact is, while targeting the people, since I studied psychology in my systems management, I thought, why not to combine psychology with wildlife tourism to get right type of customer, and at the same time to convert certain people who are not at all interested in wildlife, to make them love for wildlife and come to for wildlife tourism. With this aim, I developed this research paper. Now, human psychology is most interesting and complicated. In this research, it is successfully related to wildlife tourism in order to get maximum business and also to promote wildlife conservation, so that general public is aware of importance of wildlife. Since wildlife tourism is very expensive, already I explained to you just now, therefore research has been made for cost reduction and successfully able to select sites which are affordable, give jobs to local people, and also sites are protected by local people themselves since they get business. Types of wildlife tourism. Wildlife tourism can be broadly categorized into wild animals tourism, bird tourism, reptiles and amphibian tourism, insects and butterflies tourism, nightlife tourism, marine life tourism. Now the next type of tourism is rural and agriculture tourism. Depending on interest and financial capability of customer, one has to select site and also all rules of government to be followed. Human psychology as related to wildlife tourism. According to the psychology, 5 types of human characters are found. Joyful, open-minded character, always ready to help others. Indifferent character, close-minded. Angry character, becomes angry for small mistakes of others working with him or her. Such type of human is perfect in his work and accept everybody to be perfect like him or her working with or under him. Generally, scientists, doctors, and lawyers fall in this category. Crooked character. This type of human is ready to do anything to win. He is not bothered about feelings of others. Politicians, sportsmen, artists generally fall in this category. Sad character. Such type of human will always try to find out wrong things in others. He never highlights good things of others. Now, to target this 5 types of human character for wildlife tourism business. When person inquires about wildlife tourism, first thing one has to do is put simple and few questions just to find out under which category of human character he falls in. Whether he is a first timer or gone previously also for wildlife tour. His interest falls under which category of wildlife tourism. One can ask orally the questions or give questionnaire. My experience is the most 30% out of my experience is at the most 30% come back to you with field questionnaire. That is about by following several times. So better is to ask questions on the spot or by calling. One has to ask questions by judging his, her liking and type of human character he falls in. By answering simple questions, one can smartly judge type of character, his, her interest, and give a plan of wildlife tourism matching to his character, interest, and budget. The following questions serve most of coverage of human character, and if proper question technique is used, one can get good result to increase wildlife tourism business. The questions are, what made you to inquire about wildlife? This question will categorize in proper human character. If answer is to this question is, my friend told me about it, he is a joyful character. If answer is, you nowhere concerned about it, only tell me your tour plans, he is a crook character. If answer is, I am interested in wildlife tour, but trying to find out which type of tour is much safer, he is a close-minded character. If answer is, I know everything, give me proper budget tour, I will give you my budget and category of wildlife tour I am looking at, he is an angry type of character. If answer is, why this question? There is no use to attract me for your wildlife tour. Give me the best as compared to so and so. He always compares with others. Then he is a sad character. Other questions you can frame immediately by experience once you are sure of character of human to whom you are asking question. In case you are not able to find character of human asking only about first question, then put questions like, are you ever gone to wildlife sanctuary? If answer is yes, then find out his liking and match his needs. If no, then tell him about different types of wildlife tours to match his needs. Also ask following question. What do you expect from wildlife tour? What is your view for saving wildlife and forest? Will you recommend others our wildlife tours? And based on answer, further question can be put. Our findings. My interviewing about 200 people coming to us for inquiry indirectly for last 2 years, we came to conclusion about 50% of joyful character, 15% are close-minded, 5% are angry type, 25% are crooked, and 5% are sad type. Depending on that, you have to give the plan to your customer. Now, about the history of wildlife in India. History of wildlife or bird tourism in India. Bombay National History Society, which is present in India for more than 100 years, is known globally for doing serious research in understanding behavior of birds, identifying new species of birds, and arranging bird watching and bird ringing programs for their own members and general public at various well-known sites and national parks of India. Similarly, WWF India arranged nature trails, camps, etc. for their subscribers and nature club members. Of course, yesterday only I told, now nature club activity of World Wildlife Fund India is closed and only subscription scheme is there. About 2 years back, they have stopped concept of nature clubs. Now, our purpose is to develop a new concept in wildlife tourism. From last 8-10 years, many private organizations with thorough knowledge of wildlife started with wildlife tourism as their business. However, it still remains a niche business, which is targeted to people and families who are interested in wildlife watching, and it can be affordable by those who have enough money to spend on wildlife tourism. As already I told you, it is necessary to target a general public and to get more business, especially in India. So that you can earn better profit margin than usual tour, to well-known national parks and sites for birds. Method. How to use a method? Mouth-to-mouth publicity to advertisement in local newspaper and creative website for promoting new concept of wildlife tourism. Restrict groups of maximum 30 people with one expert with every 6 tourists. Select sites not far off but within the vicinity of group where they are staying if they do not want to spend much money. Selection of sites. For bird watching, it can be terrace, balcony within city where group of bird watchers staying nearby, maybe one or more sites of group's participation residences where nearby trees are there. One full day or half day bird watching maybe during weekend can be arranged. See the bird through binocular or even take photographs. The site should be such, it should be easy to take photographs also. Give checklist of birds in the vicinity to identify, carry bird book to identify birds. At the end of bird watching, make a list of bird seen. Make any new birds not mentioned in the checklist previously. Develop a file on computer and register observations on well-known bird sites apps for general public awareness. For economic wildlife tourism, go out of city nearby. Choose a site in farm, field, forest, lake where wildlife is there. Stay maybe maximum 1 or 2 nights. Also make aware of local wildlife to people staying nearby to those sites for showing them films, slideshows and make them interested to conserve nature and wildlife since they are local people staying there. You can also train them for bird watching. Now, advantage of new concept. If compared to usual cost of visiting a well-known wildlife sanctuary where one has to pay for staying in good resort, it can be reduced. Transport, entry fee, guide, etc. can be avoided if you are selected sites are nearby. Since promoted to general public, they become aware of importance of wildlife, birds and its conservation in their vicinity, creating interest in them to help conserve the birds. Mouth-to-mouth publicity helps to increase business. And this I have tried in my Mumbai city, and I came to know those even who are not knowing about birds at all, now taking interest. Those organizers who are arranging bird watching trips can charge good fees for their guidance and expertise to bird watching and photography, which comes more than profit margin by arranging far-off camp to well-known bird sanctuary. This is because since one is charging little fee to general public who may not be rich, response becomes more and therefore profit margin increases. With new concept of advantages are financial, already explained to you, less cost to customer and increased profit margin to wildlife tour operator. Conservation, since this is promoted to general public and that also wildlife of their own vicinity. The interest in wildlife, they themselves conserve them and also do tree planting, making water available for wildlife during summer. And this especially happened in my Mumbai city. Now people are aware of birds in that vicinity. Even they are injured, they call the right people to take care of the bird. So this is slowly, awareness is increasing in our Mumbai city, and I am sure it must be happening in other cities of India also. Since we are not going for wildlife watching in well-known wildlife sanctuaries, no much crowd is present in little known farms, lake, forest, which may be rich in wildlife species. So one can spend hours together with wild animals, birds, undisturbed by any noise of crowd. Sometimes my experience is, one can see rare bird species in such location, easily photographed, then to search them in well-known bird sanctuaries. I can give you one example, great adjacent stork and a laser adjacent stork, which is a rare species in Northeast India, that is near Guwahati. In Guwahati city, there is a site where they throw garbage and there lots of laser and greater adjacent stocks come, and tourists and even a scientist go there to photograph. if you go in Kaziranga, you may see one or two. Here you will seeing in maybe hundreds. So that's what I'm trying to explain. In well-known, even some of the bird species which are not easily seen in well-known bird species may be seen in such species. I have developed a mathematical formula for new concept of wildlife tourism, of course, based on the question which is asked to people to find out how he is fit in the psychology. And this mathematical formula I developed 2 years back, and that time I represented my paper called Bird Tourism in Sri Lanka in their International Wildlife Conference of Bird Tourism and Bird Biodiversity. And afterward, this formula has been used by many people, including my friends who are having similar type of business like me, and some are having not wildlife business but other tour business, and they come back to me feedback. They said, yes, because of your formula and guidance, now we are getting 20%, 25% more tourists attracted to us. So now my formula is known, and I made it name as Dr. Sangiri's formula in that conference of Sri Lanka. So same formula I'm explaining you here also. We are interested in wildlife bird watching. If the general cost is C, interest is I, accepted awareness is A, conservation effort is E, it is proved that accepted awareness plus interest minus cost is equal to conservation effort. For example, if awareness created by organizer is 70%, accepted by general public is 40%, interest created due to awareness is 20%, cost bear by general public becomes 10%. Then accepted awareness, same formula, figures are fitted in my formula. This is generally for successful for first trip. As interest becomes more, conservation effort by general public will be more. Conclusion, the new concept of wildlife tourism will increase interest of general public in wildlife and bird, which ultimately help in bird conservation and indirectly nature and other wildlife conservation. So also people staying in vicinity of forest, lake, farm, where we are visiting for wildlife viewing, bird watching, if made aware of the local bird and wild animal, trees, etc., and their importance, then they only will protect them. This is because due to visit of tourists in their area, it increases their various types of local business. Since wildlife tourism is commercial, it also takes care of minimum cost to general public with maximum profit margin. Now I am going to show you some photographs where most of them are clicked in such type of site which is not a national park, and I will explain you if I remember which site it was clicked. Now this is a jungle babbler. It is clicked near my residence only in Airport Colony. Next one is this duck, which is a Brahmini duck, or it is called ruddy duck. It is clicked somewhere in Maharashtra near some small village. Now this one is a tree pie clicked near my residence in Airport Colony.
Sorry, Dr. Sansgiri, to interrupt, but we do not see the pictures. I think you have to switch screens. We still see this text.
Can you see now?
Yes, perfect. Thank you.
So let's start from beginning. Hello?
Yes, I think first picture.
No, perfect.
Let's start from the first picture.
I'll go a little fast if the time do not permit. This is a jungle. Can you see, madam?
Yes, yes.
This is a jungle babbler clicked near my residence in Airport Colony. This is a Brahmini duck, which is clicked somewhere in Maharashtra, small village, lake, which is near to to the village only. This is a tree pie in airport colony. This is three-striped palm squirrel in airport colony. This is a turtle. Somewhere it is clicked, as I remember, near this famous bird sanctuary, Bharatpur. This is a white-breasted kingfisher in Sanjay Gandhi National Park buffer zone. This is a rat snake clicked somewhere near Sanjay Gandhi National Park. This is a spotted owlet clicked in airport colony. This is a peacock near Sanjay Gandhi National Park. This is a bison. This is what I want to tell you. Now, big animal like bison also come. This is clicked in Goa, near Molem Sanctuary, in some agriculture farm, which they have started this agriculture tourism. So in that farm, the bison also comes. This is again yellow wattle diving somewhere in near Tarova National Park, in those areas, but outside Tarova. This is spotted deer near Sanjay Gandhi National Park. As I remember, it is clicked near Kim City of Bombay Natural History Society Research Center. This is again a blue jay, Indian blue jay, clicked in airport colony. Same with more, same nesting site with more owlets. A peacock clicked near Sanjay Gandhi National Park. This is a honey buzzard clicked somewhere nearby Tarova National Park. And this is orange-headed thrush clicked in airport colony. This is spotted deer near Sanjay Gandhi National Park. And this is a beetle, ladybird, which is clicked in airport colony. And this is how we sometimes make a machan. Of course, this machan, which I'm showing the photo, is during the census of wild animals during night in Sanjay Gandhi National Park. But similar type of machan or whatever can be erected in the agricultural farm with the help of local people. So they get business by way of such things. And at the same time, they themselves then protect the wildlife. And there they can also be trained as a good bird watcher in local language when local people come as a tourist. Thank you. Any questions?
Thank you very much for this very interesting presentation. It is indeed so important. I'm gonna switch my video on. It is so important to make local communities also aware of this beautiful wildlife that is around them. So it was very fascinating to hear about your concept. Does anyone from the attendees have questions before I ask my questions? I would be interested, how do you usually count general acceptance and awareness? So you mentioned this mathematical method. How do you count it, basically? Do you do questionnaires or what kind of methods do you use?
Right. I got a wildlife business of my own, that is Nilkan Wildlife Safari. And this I thought, when I came to know that there is a lot of competition to me with well-known tour operators, which are already there in India, then how to target and increase my business? That was my thinking. So I thought, why not to target general public who cannot afford? Then next question was, some of the general public are aware of wildlife, but some of them may not be interested. So I wanted to attract them also. So I started studying, because I already learned psychology, to see how to ask questions. But now any public tendency is, if you give form, you must be also having experience. They take their own time to give you feedback, or sometimes you have to follow so many times. So simple way is just to ask oral questions, few of them, and try to find out by experience. Of course, I'm experienced in this. So which category of psychology he feels in, and then ask other questions to him quickly, one after another, and then ultimately come to the conclusion that which wildlife is it. And I have got experience, even those who are, as you have said, of awareness, those are not at all interested in wildlife. And those who are hating in wildlife, now they are coming back to me. Why? Because they have now fed up with usual tours, going to see some Taj Mahal or something. Now they want something else. And when they come to know, yeah, this is also interesting. And once they enter, then they are always my customer. Hello.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the answer.
Any more question?
I do not see any more questions in the chat or the Q&A box. So in that case, thank you very much for your presentation. It was very interesting to hear about human psychology. Mm-hmm.